Two approaches are reported in the literature for joint space trajectory planning, and they are polynomials of different orders and linear functions with parabolic blends. So first we will discuss this method, that is polynomials of different orders for making or for doing joint space trajectory planning. So suppose we have two joint angles, that is initial and final, and we want to move the joint from this initial angle to this final angle. So we can force the joint to follow this trajectory, or we may force the joint to follow this trajectory or this trajectory. All three joints, all these three joints will have different spline functions that can be defined with help of different orders polynomials. Let's take an example of third order polynomial. In case of third order polynomial, we need at least four constraints to define this third order polynomial. So we need at least four constraints. Two constraints can be obtained from the initial and final positions, and another two constraints can be obtained from initial and final velocities. In most cases, the initial and final velocities are zero if the robot indicator is starting from the rest and stopping at the rest. So this constraint helps us to retain the continuity. These constants can be identified as follows. So we have these four initial conditions. If we take the first derivative of this polynomial, then we will get this expression. After substituting all these conditions, initial conditions, we will get these equations. So this equation will give us the constant C naught. This equation will give us the constant C1. So two constants, C naught and C1 are identified. The remaining two, that is C2 and C3, can be solved using these two equations. Two equations, two unknowns. Let's take an example. Here in this example, a single link robot with a rotary joint is motionless at theta is equal to 15 degrees. That means theta I is equal to 15. It is desired to move the joint in a smooth manner to theta is equal to 75 degrees. So theta F is equal to 75 degrees. In 3 seconds, that means T final is 3 seconds and T initial is equal to 0 seconds. Find the coefficients of cubic that accomplishes this motion and brings the manipulator to rest at the goal. Plot the position, velocity and acceleration of the joint as a function of time. So here is the cubic equation. And we need to find the coefficients a naught, a1, a2, a3. We can put t is equal to 0, so a naught will be equal to 15 degrees. A naught is equal to 15. Take first derivative of this expression, so we will get to theta dot is equal to a1 plus 2a2t plus 3a3t. And initially, indicator was at rest, so if we put t is equal to 0, then we will get a1 is equal to 0. After substituting the values of a naught, a1 in this equation, we get theta t. Just put t is equal to 3 seconds and theta is equal to 75 degrees. We will get one equation. Then take its first derivative, we will get theta dot t. Now put t is equal to 3 and theta dot is equal to 0. You will get another expression. So just solve these two expressions for t is equal to 3 seconds and you will get the unknowns a2 and a3, and their values will be a2 is equal to 20, a3 is equal to minus 4.44. So finally we will get the expression of theta t is equal to 15 plus 20 t square minus 4.44 t cube. If we take its first derivative, then we will get the velocity, that is theta dot, that will be equal to 40t minus 13.33t square. After taking the second derivative of this equation, we will get theta double dot is equal to 40 minus 26.66c. and just plot these two equations and you will get these curves. So for any order of polynomial, we get these the following boundary conditions, and these boundary conditions are like this. Suppose I have defined two intermediate points t1 and t2 between initial and final time. So corresponding to these four times, I will get these boundary conditions. So the first boundary condition is regarding the initial position velocity acceleration. Boundary condition for position velocity and acceleration at point t1. So we will get continuity in position at t1. That means one value of position at this time can be obtained from this equation, and another value of position can be obtained from polynomial of this path. Same thing can be applied on the position at point t2, velocity and at point t2, acceleration at point t2. Then the other boundary condition will be on final position, velocity and acceleration. So corresponding to this point of time, we can find the position, velocity and acceleration. That will give us another boundary condition. So if we take this fifth order polynomial and we try to find a0, a1, a2, a3, a4 and a5, then we will need to follow this step. So first, put t is equal to 0 and we will get theta is equal to 0, that is theta naught is equal to a0. Then put t is equal to t final and we will get one constraint like this, theta f is equal to 0. Then take first derivative of this equation and we will get theta 0 dot is equal to a1 for t is equal to 0. Similarly, the final velocity is theta dot f, that will be obtained by putting t is equal to tf. Then theta double dot 0 is equal to 2a2, it will be obtained by putting t is equal to 0. Similarly, theta double dot f will be equal to 2a2 plus 6a3 tf plus 12a4 tf square plus 20a5 tf2. So in this way, how many constraints we have obtained? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So here I have used only boundary conditions corresponding to T0 and TF, but you can also get the boundary conditions at point T1 and point T2 like this. Let's take one example. So in this example, we need to solve for the coefficients of two cubics that are connected in two segment is line with continuous acceleration at the intermediate wire point. The angle, the initial angle is theta 0 and the wire point is theta v and the goal point is theta g. Okay, so the cubic equation for this path is this one, and the cubic equation for this path is this. So for this polynomial, we will take the limit of t from 0 to t f1, and for this polynomial, the limit of time will be from 0 to t f2. Okay, next to put t is equal to 0 in this equation, and this will give theta 0 is equal to a1 0, where theta 0 is the position at t is equal to 0. And put t is equal to 0 in this equation, and this will give us theta v is equal to a2 0, and this theta v is the position corresponding to this position, and for this position t is equal to 0 for this expression. Then if we put t is equal to tf1 in this equation, that means we are talking about this polynomial, and t is equal to tf1 will give this position. That means theta v is equal to a10 plus a11 tf1 plus a12 tf1 square plus a13 tf1 cube. Next, put t is equal to tf2 in this equation. That means we are talking about this polynomial, and t is equal to tf2 means this position. And this position is theta g, and in the right hand side you will get this expression in tf2. Next, to take derivative of this equation, and we will get theta dot is equal to, this will be not be there, a11 t will not be there, plus twice a12 t plus twice a13 t square. And if we put t is equal to 0 in this equation, we will get initial velocity is 0, so 0 is equal to a11. And if we take this expression and we take derivative, then we will get theta dot t is equal to, this will not be there, a 2 1 t will be cancelled, and 2 a 2 2 t plus 3 a 2 3 t square. And if we put t is equal to t of 2, then the velocity at final position will be 0. So we will get 0 velocity, and this left hand side will be a 2 1 plus twice a 2 2 t of 2 plus twice a 2 3 t of 2 square. Next, put t is equal to t of 1 in the derivative of this equation, and what it will indicate? It will indicate the velocity corresponding to this path at this position. So at this position, the velocity will be equal to a 1 1 plus twice a 1 2 t of 1 plus twice a 1 2 t of 1, and the velocity of this point can also be obtained from this polynomial by putting t is equal to 0 in this equation. T is equal to 0. So just take the derivative of this equation, and by putting t is equal to 0, we will get the velocity as a 2 1. So we will get this expression. Next, take second derivative of this expression, theta t double dot, and this will give twice, these terms will not be there, so we will get 2 a 1 2 t, only 2 a 1 2 plus 6 a 1 3 t. So if you put t is equal to t of 1, then that means we are getting acceleration at this point b, and this acceleration can also be obtained by using the polynomial of this segment by putting t is equal to 0. So acceleration of this segment will be, these terms will not be there in the second derivative, and here this will be only 2 a 2 2, and here it will be 6 a 2 3 into t. And if you put t is equal to 0, then we will get 2 a 2 2 acceleration by this expression is equal to twice a 2 2, and this equation will give twice a 1 2 plus twice a 1 2 plus 6 a 1 3 t of 1. Just equate this part and we will get finally 2 a 1 2 plus 6 a 1 3 t of 1 is equal to 2 a 2 2. So just use these 8 equations and solve all the unknowns. There are 8 unknowns and 8 equations, so we can solve.